Love.
It's a nice confident start there from Pulkanova.
One all.
I was just wondering after this second point where she's had to move around, is that strapping, that brace she's wearing on her right knee, doesn't seem to be affecting the mobility right now.
In some senses, it should be helping her. She wouldn't be wearing it if it wasn't. But as mentioned, with this much prize money and points available, everyone will be here if they can. If you sprained an ankle and it's not going to end your career, you will be here.
And just to reiterate that point, 4.5 hours she spent on court so far, Volkanova.
So in terms of game, Xu Hui there, coach on the Chinese side, used to play in Europe. Sofia Pulkanova, one of the tallest players, the tallest player in the women's game.
5'11" or so, almost 6 foot.
I'm going to say 6 foot, actually tied with Monica Batra. I think the two of them must be just exactly the same or just about, which means that she's going to have a bigger middle section, a crossover point. Qian Tianyi is going to be looking for that elbow. Sofia Pulkanova is going to be playing with the backhand in front of the elbow more. As you could see right there, and this is tactically a big part of the game, both men's and women's, but in the women's game where speed and close to the table play, reaction time is the greater test, that efficient stroke, the backhand, will be used quite a lot until there's time to turn to play a big forehand or you're forced to.
Three, four.
We're matching each other at the moment in these rallies. Good work.
Nice change of depth there. Second to last shot, shallow behind the net. Next one deep to the corner.
Four all.
So earlier that these two have had two meetings so far within the space of about a month in 2019. German Open, followed by the Austrian Open, the home tournament for Pulkanova.
Four, five.
It's good stuff at the moment for Pulkanova.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy to win these long rallies on top of the heavy topspin with the backhand. Fortunately for Pulkanova, she's got the height to stay on top of the ball. Still takes a lot of work to keep that elbow up and continue topspinning. 12 shots in that last rally. That's a bit of an outlier at this point.
Six, four.
Yeah, I was just going to add that they've had some good meetings. The first one ended 4-3, Chen Tianyu's favor. The second one, 4-2. So they were evenly matched, but it was 3.5 years ago.
6-5.
So just to be clear, Chen Tianyu would have been 19, 20.
Yeah.
That's still a lot of developing.
Correct. A lot has changed, I'm sure, since then. Pulkanova leads by one here.
5-7.
I like the placement on this one. Wide to the, excuse me. Yeah. Wait a second.
On the backhand.
Backhand side. It's wide to the backhand side. We got two left-handed players here. Normally that is a forehand for others, but just an uncomfortable ball to banana flick.
Let 5-7.
Often you'll see players creeping over the forehand side. Good morning.
Make sure you got that right. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're in Singapore, by the way.
6-7.
It's gone long there in the backhand. Chen Tianyi down by one. That's lovely. Put away by Chen Tianyi to draw level.
Not an easy task to hit it outside of the reach of Sofia Pulkanova. Yeah. Not by a lot there, but even with the leaping, lunging, long levers, not able to grab it.
8-7.
What an alliteration that was. Leaping, lunging, long levers.
Love I thought it. You'd love it.
Let 8-7. 8 all.
She turned that round, didn't she, Chen Tianyi?
It really felt like she was on the response on the defense in this, under pressure. And as soon as the forehand comes out, look how wide that ball is. We might even see a heat map of that later, but that exits the side of the table. Really a risky shot.
Yeah.
8-9.
Volkanova just in front. Right at the business end of this game. And she has two game points here, the Austrian.
This first game could be quite crucial. Again, it is a best of seven. Remember that. It is our first day where someone has to win four games, so a long way to go. We'll tend to favor the stronger player, less likely to see upsets.
And
it's Volkanova takes the first game, 11-8.
Every game is as important as can be. Balancing stamina.
Love one.
I would have to imagine. So the difference between a sprint and, say, an extra lap, you know, you have
pace
to consider
yourself.
That as well, to pace yourself a little bit. But tactically, every game is so important and every point is so important. There's not going to be much.
One all.
I think they're really going to be fighting. I think in some senses it's also going to be a question of belief, right? You always want to start with the first game on the board. It's just a smaller slice of the pie in a best of seven.
2-1.
I think what we briefly discussed it yesterday, though, at least here, a 3-0. If you're down 3-0, you still have that lifeline, at least one more game to extend.
Right.
2-all.
It's a little bit more of a lottery the less games you play. A little bit more, favors the lower ranked player a little bit more.
Yes.
2-3.
She adjusted off that, Volkanova, but it's Tianyi who wins the point.
4-2.
Is it quite often when a Chinese player goes a game down, you always get the impression that the following game is sort of a point to be made?
Yeah.
I mean, obviously every player wants to make a point.
5-2.
But it just seems even more so when a Chinese player seems to lose a game.
Right. The pressure is completely different on the Chinese national team than anywhere in the world. For the coaching staff, for the player, there is a determination and an expectation that is unrivaled.
2-6.
Before you know it, she's
well prepared and well studied. There is no shortage of time and resource put into table tennis in China.
3-6.
Take us through that serve from Volkanova at the moment.
So the reverse pendulum serve is a serve that is not so common. I think left-handed players do it a bit. You see hook serves more.
7-3.
But that reverse pendulum serve, Matilda Ekholm of Sweden used to do it incredibly well. She put a tutorial out online about it. But basically, the elbow moves way out in front. The handle of the racket comes over the wrist. It's one of the toughest serves in the game.
7-4.
And the reason someone would work on it is if the opponent isn't very familiar with it, it's going to be tougher for them to calibrate their game. For a right-handed player, it can be awkward for them to come in and banana flick that serve.
Except she's playing a lefty. And actually,
exactly.
She tried that there. Volkanova.
Right. So a lot of the factor, it's funny, you might think, oh, left-handed players should be very used to playing a left-handed player, but no, it's rare.
Because they're not facing that many either.
Exactly.
4-9.
So, okay, a lefty to lefty, what might the thinking be then in that case? Strategy.
Well, it's going to be the same typically as anyone else adjusting to a lefty.
Ah, she changed it up, doesn't she?
Yeah, she went traditional on the pendulum serve. So 6 game points now for Chen Tianyi. In terms of tactics, both players are going to be looking to find weaknesses, keep the opponent uncomfortable on the receive, hit to the middle.
10-5.
But in terms of identifying weaknesses, you might think your first choice is to play your strongest game, but not always. It depends on who you're facing and what their strengths are.
Horses for courses, as they say.
6-10.
A couple of points here for Paul Canova to reduce the deficit. Just 4 game points.
Seven, 10.
Nice little run from her here, Paul Canova.
So one thing that the game being best of seven might change is the timing of a timeout. That's a big factor. We do see the Chinese national team calling timeouts earlier than others. You could imagine there were some questions about that now.
11-7.
So point has been made by Chen Tianyi. Orthodox serve from Chen Tianyi than what we've seen generally from Paul Canova.
And a little break off the net there for that last one. You can see the jump completely changes the timing in such a fast game.
Let love one. One all.
Yeah, she's looking in a happier place overall, generally. And we saw earlier in the build-up to this match that she's got a very good winning record against fellow left-handers.
Yeah, and you can see her timing. She's so quick off the bounce, it's going to make force Polkanova behind the table.
2-1.
2-2. Take another look here over the table. Beautiful flick there. It's the backhand way inside, drives it right into the middle. Oh, blasting backhand, just blistering the ball here. Right on top of it once again. Chen Tianyi able to recoil. Slow one there. And a little bit more time, a more decisive backhand. Deep to the corner. If she can keep this up, it's going to be a very tough match for Austria's Sofia Polkanova.
3-4.
Originally from Moldova, has played professionally for Austria and done wonders.
Let 3-4. 4-all.
Now these are the sort of rallies that they were enjoying in the first game.
'So as the table gets cleaned here, I just got word that tickets are running out for the weekend, Friday and Saturday night. The courtside seats are sold out. The Platinum Lounge.
5-4.
Yeah, it's been very good. They've sold more tickets this year than last year. It's getting more and more in the public consciousness.
I like the way this is moving. I think the Smash Park definitely calls a lot of attention around the arena here.
4-6. How about that for a rally? Best one, longest one, surely.
And Polkanova thought it was over. She clinched her fist. It's the second time we've seen that corner exploited. There it is, the Cho, premature Cho. Cho, no. Chen Tianyi, one more shot back.
There you go, 13.
John,
Did you say six. Chono?
Yes, I did. That was sort of my, thank you, that was sort of my lip read of how she must feel in that moment.
We had that yesterday as well, didn't we?
Sure did. Ju Chunwei.
7-5.
Who's in action later on. Chen Tenyu moves two in front. Oh, that's got to be so frustrating when you think you've done it.
Because you have this never give up attitude. And it's almost like you accidentally gave up early. It's just a reminder. It's a slap, you know, shake my head moment. Face palm.
8-5.
With three ahead, Chen Tenyu in a good position. Yes, now doesn't look very happy, does she? Wonder if that's a bit of a turning point, that point earlier, that rally.
Mentally, it can be quite tough to recover from. In terms of regrets, yeah, you have to put the past behind you, but you can learn from it. And I think that's the type of lesson people have learned from the time they were kids in this sport.
6-9. 10-6.
Quality push there. Deep to the baseline. And 4 game points now, Chen Tianyi. Quite a turnaround after being beaten in the first, but remember, a best of seven, so a long road here. Good length on the push. Sometimes a fast push can be a very effective shot. Typically thought of as a defensive shot, but can be used to surprise the opponent or even play aggressively, as we just saw.
8-10.
Well, she's been quite good at pulling some points back when Chen Tianyi's on game point, but it's too little too late, you could argue.
Still within reach, no doubt about it.
Yeah.
Just 2 points between them.
11-8. Game
that has gifted.
Which we could describe as not Wunda anything, but yeah, that she wasn't able to play the shots she wanted.
Yeah. Love that was a frustration about how she was reacting to things out, talking to the coach.
Spielen,
yep.
Not playing.
2-love.
That'd be funny if I got it completely wrong.
Oh, I heard those two words as well. They're from my 3 years of learning German a long time ago. Yeah, that's what I got out of it.
3-love.
Yeah, the body language wasn't great, but and Chen Tianyi's racing away here again.
We had a chance to look at the draw earlier, and I think the draw for me was a reminder that while two of the top four seeds were eliminated, two very strong Chinese players.
Yeah.
The world number three, Wang Yibi, and the world number two, Chen Meng. Mm. There is still a decent chance that we could see four Chinese players in the semifinals. But right now, there are four matches, China versus non-Chinese players in the quarters.
Five.
There's no all-Chinese affair as of now. Yeah.
Right.
Not yet.
Yeah. Timeout here. This is a tough time for a timeout. We talked about how timeouts change. Occasionally slower shots, a little inside the table, depth change.
6-love.
That's a beautiful winner from Chen Tianyi on the backhand.
Yeah, there's not, I mean, when you watch a point like this, you can think all you want and describe what you think might work, and you never know, but she's not leaving a lot of room for improvement, Chen Tianyi. Oh, that's a beautiful counter.
They've just matched each other there on wonderful backhands.
Took a real risk on that second one. Chen Tianyi was just a step behind after she tried to lean towards the corner.
1-7.
We could only see it in the replay, really, the point before this, where Chen Tianyi just started to lean to the backhand corner, and it cost her just a little bit of balance. 12 of the last 16 points for Chen Tianyi.
2-7. 8-2.
So three of the last 5 points since that timeout have gone Chen's way.
Eight, three.
Saw a little space to be exploited there. Volkanova.
A taste of her own medicine, really, for Chen Tieni. Rare that we see her coming down like that. It just goes to show you, you leave your feet for a moment. Yeah. That's how quickly the ball is back.
Correct.
3-9.
It was always tough, wasn't it? At love five down to go in for that timeout, hoping to turn it around. Not saying you can't do it, but it's just, it's a long way to go, isn't it?
Still more common to see a 3-point differential. 0-3, you might see it normally.
Right.
3-10.
You could argue that the timeout was taken a little bit late, yeah. Unconventionally late.
Yeah. 7 game points here for Chen Tieni to take a 3-1 lead.
10.
So this is kind of being the pattern for the last couple of games where Chen's on game point and then Volkanova rattles off a few points.
Just hasn't been enough since game two.
Yeah.
10-5.
It comes just a little too late for Volkanova.
Remember, Chen Tieni beating Mima Ito the way she did really shows how mentally strong she is and how quickly she adapts.
11-5.
There we go. Another game for Chen Tieni. To stay in the match.
1-love.
Very, very good on that backhand, isn't she? Chen Tieni.
I'm still thinking about the placement of the winners. Just a reminder, though, that's only the final shot of the rally.
Love.
Like that one, except that was on the forehand. But yeah.
Right, exactly. That was a bit of an outlier. I think it just goes to show you, though, that she's been very selective about when she does go for that forehand, that she's playing around in the middle a lot, looking for opportunities.
1-2.
Volkanova doing a good job here to change the percentages, to derail it. She's going to have to get aggressive. She's going to have to add extra spin near the table. As a taller player, that's not as easy.
2-all.
Over the table, yes. Having that long reach to get inside, that can be very effective. Backhand flick there, as you see. But then right back into the slightly behind the table, just right at the baseline game. That's where most of the rallies are going to need to be.
3-2.
And if I'm her coach, if I'm Zhang Jie in the corner for Austria, I say, yes, that's right. You missed the shot, okay, but you took the right shot and you didn't back up. You have to stay there.
2-4.
Okay. Showing that she can do it as well on the forehand. Some excellent shots from her.
Thousands and thousands of hours practiced, returning the ball right at the back of the table. Mistakes are made. This is what practice is all about. Figuring out how to reduce the rate of error when you're taking these low percentage shots.
2-4.
Chen Tieni incredibly stable right now at the back of the table.
2-5.
Again, this is where she has that surge that leaves Volkanova trailing. Far too much work to do.
2-5. Five, three.
Beautiful cross-court shot there right off the bounce. Volkanova quick to go with that one. Takes it early. Spin comes in. That's probably going to be the most lukewarm shot she gets in a rally anytime soon.
5-4.
That said, she's earning her opportunities here. She got two back there. She's keeping the pressure on early. If Chen Tieni has to have a more responsive shot, something where she can't quite predict where the ball's going, she's not going to be able to get in powerfully early.
4-6.
I was about to say that Volkanova has not been this close mid-game since game one.
So now or never time here.
Yeah, exactly.
Good placement there. Chen Tianyi saying, try to play a backhand from it about chest height. And of course, Volkanova stepping around.
5-6. Six all.
Well, she's must surely be happier with this, Volkanova. Can she surge ahead?
It's interesting. Sofia Volkanova, last time I saw her in Qatar, had a blood blister under her pinky nail from attacking a shot in practice at the baseline of the table.
7-6.
And here she manages to escape it, but she's right there at the back of the table.
Yeah.
This is a must for players. Yeah, it hurts sometimes, and you can be afraid, especially after an injury, but she needs to make those shots, and she's not afraid to take them, as you see.
6-8.
Oh, look, snatching at the ball there. Volkanova, annoyed.
Excellent short serve here. Half long, low to the net, second bounce. You could say probably 5 centimeters inside the baseline. Really good shorter half long serve.
6-9.
And the crowd loving a bit of a chop block
here. Yeah, really nicely done in the serve receive.
Oh, chop blocks are so pretty. Look at the curve on that.
10-6.
Match points, 4 of them. Chen Tianyi.
Game and match.
So Chen Tianyi has put out Sofia Volkanova. Another seed is gone.